this video, I am going to show you how to use the Navigation Pane in Microsoft Word. This is not a new feature in Word by any means, but I do think that it is one that is tremendously underutilized. It's a little bit buried in Word, and therefore I think a lot of people just don't even know that it's there. So first let's talk about what is the Navigation Pane in Microsoft Word. So to see the Navigation Pane, you go right up to the View tab, and there's this little checkbox here, Navigation Pane, and when you check that, you see this whole outline view of your document show up on the left-hand side. Now, this is not anything that prints. It's not part of the document itself. Its sole function in life is to just help you get around a document. So you can use this especially when you have a longer document that you are working with and one that you're editing, that you're making changes to, if you have to jump around a lot. If you find yourself scrolling on and on and on, or if you find yourself hitting Control F and doing a find all of the time to try to find keywords to get to a certain place in your document, then those are the kinds of cases where Navigation Pane really comes in handy. The sample that I'm showing you today is only 9 pages long, but in the course of my work, sometimes we deal with 50-page, 100-page documents, and I don't know what I would do without the Navigation tab. So I'm going to take you through the major features of the Navigation tab and explain each one, and explain how you would use this to move around in a large document. So the first tab I want to show you on the Navigation Pane is this Headings tab. That's what comes up by default when you pull up the Navigation Pane. And just as the name suggests, this shows every heading in your document. Now, what does Microsoft Word consider a heading? Well, it is anything that has the heading styles applied. So let's take a look at our styles for a quick second. And I just clicked on the Home tab. And you can see the styles here in about the middle of your row here of your ribbon on the Home tab. I find this view is very hard to use. So one other trick that I do when I want to look at styles is I expand using this little arrow on the bottom right, and all the styles in my document show up over here on the right hand side. Again, this is not something that prints as part of your document. This is a helper window that Word gives you to be able to see things better. So if I put my cursor on my first heading, you can see that that is formatted as a heading 1 style. And so all of that is to say that anything with a heading style, heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, and so on, will show up in this Navigation tab under, or Navigation window under the Headings tab. So let's close out the Styles pane here, and let's look back over here at the Navigation Pane. So what are some of the things that you can do? Well, the first thing is that let's say that you are typing along in the introduction, and let's say that you type an acronym and you have an acronyms list in the appendix of the document. Well, that's all the way down at the bottom. You don't want to have to scroll, scroll, scroll. That's for the birds, and it gets really old really fast. So you can just tap on the place in the document where you want to go, and it jumps right there. Do you see that? And so then you can type in your acronym. And then you can go right back up to the introduction where you were just working. So you can just click wherever you want to go in the document. Let's say, oh, I remember in this introduction, I need to add some content to my web applications section. So you click on that heading in the navigation pane, takes you right down there. Okay, very simple. Now, let's take a look at another really powerful feature while we are still here on the Headings tab, and that is the ability to completely rearrange and move around entire sections of your document. Now, you may already know that you can take pieces of your document and you can highlight them and you can cut them and you can paste them somewhere else. I'm going to undo what I just did because there's a much easier way. Let's say that I want to move the internal facing web applications and I want it to be above public facing web applications. So here's internal facing, and right above it, I have this paragraph public facing web applications. So you can just click on the heading in the navigation pane, click and drag, and you can put that wherever you want it to in the outline order. And see how Word highlighted that entire section for me and moved it. And so, just to prove it, here we have public website, internal, public facing, public website, there's internal, there's public facing. So, everything is in the order as I dragged it around. You can take any level, it will stay at the same level. And let's say I wanted to take something from section 5.3 and move it under 5.1. And there it is. And look how Word manages that numbering for you. Now, another thing that you can do is I just noticed that in my document here, I skip from a level 1 heading all the way to a level 3 heading. That's not right. I'm not following good outline numbering rules. So if you click on whatever section you want to become that first section at level 2, watch this. You can go right up here. I'm on the Home tab and see these outdent and indent buttons right there. If I do this, look at that. It moved my heading level from a heading 3 to a heading 2. It fixed all my numbering below it, and now I'm going to roll on with life. So there's no manually numbering anything. If you don't know how to do this numbering in Word documents, I have another video here on my channel about hierarchical numbering and outline numbering in Word, where we go through all of that in a lot of detail. But this is just such a powerful way to move content around when you're editing documents, when you're collaborating with your team, and they say, oh, Gina, I need you to move all of these sections all around. Well, that used to be something that might possibly ruin my day, but now that I have navigation pane, which we've had for a long time, then you can just move these things around very easily. Now, there are a couple of other features here that are a little more hidden. The first one is this tiny little bar at the top. What this does is jump to the beginning of the document. So, very nice feature, especially if you're having, again, to do a lot of jumping back and forth. Let's say that you are adding different items and you need to jump back to the beginning to make sure that those items are included in your introduction. Then this is a great way to do that. So that's jump to the beginning. Now let's look at the next tab in the navigation pane, and that is the Pages tab. This is really cool because it gives you a picture of each one of your pages in the document. And so if you know, I need to jump to that map graphic and look at something there and reference it. Again, instead of having to scroll all the way through, you just click on that page. Oh, I need to look at the page. I know my content is on the page with the picture of the man and the woman in training. So we jump to that, and there you go. So it's just another really nice way to be able to jump around into a document without having to scroll. And then finally, the results pane. Now when you click on this, it looks like really this doesn't do anything. But actually, you can type anything, and this same pane is now what comes up when you do a Control F, as in Frank. So if you tap Control F on your keyboard, it brings you to this spot, or you can manually go here. And let's say that you don't remember where something is in the document, but you want to find mentions of the word data. Then you can go ahead and type that in. And the nice thing about this view is that it will show you every match in a list. So if the navigation pane is not up and you type Control F, see how that comes up for you now? So that is a really nice feature. It makes it really easy for me. Now I know I want to find this database list section. This is where I want to make my change. And so there you have it. Just to review, 3 tabs in the navigation pane: headings, pages, and results, which is your find feature. And in the headings, the things that show up here are lines that have heading styles applied to them. Thank you for watching. If you would like other free training, feel free to take a look at my website or click on other videos here on the channel. We're at Young Career Pros on YouTube and GinaNaren.com. If you are looking for other tutorials in Word, feel free to leave me a comment, and I will do my best to make as many videos as I can to help as many people as I can. Thanks, and have a great day. Thank you.